Hey guys, Ray from loveyourrv.com. So I'm back here today to do a review and a little modification, a little power output modification for my VIAIR air compressor that I got for Christmas from Anne. It's been on my wish list for a while and I finally got it. I'm using kind of a crappy old air compressor called a slime, really noisy, takes forever to top up the tires, but this is supposed to be kind of one of the Cadillacs of air compressors. This is the 450P-RV model of the VIAIR, and it can go up to 150 PSI and inflate up to a 42-inch tire. It also can handle 100% duty cycle. So you can run this thing straight out, they say, for about 40 minutes before you need to let it rest. Another feature it has is it automatically shuts off. So if it's pumping along and you're not putting air in the tire, it'll shut off until you use the air again. Unlike some pumps, it'll just run straight out, you know. So it's a pretty cool little pump. Let's see what we got in the bag on this kit here. It comes with two 30-foot coiled up hoses, so that easily can get all the way around the rig. Over here we've got a different selection of inflator chucks here. We got one that's a screw on and kind of a flexible rubber. I guess that's to get it hard to get at spots, low clearance spots. Then you got your standard big 45 and 90 degree filler there. That's really nice to get into the dualies to fill them. And then it comes, this is really cool, comes with a kind of a gas station style trigger pump with a gauge on it. Looks like it's really well built. The whole machine looks really well built. So this thing goes for around $219 currently, I think, on Amazon. And that's quite the name brand. Still, when I look it up, it's still made in China. So I've had a lot of people, when I first showed that I got this pump, they were saying, you know, you can get a lot cheaper one from Harbor Freight, all kinds of different models and stuff, as low as like sort of the same looking thing for around $60. But I think I decided to go with the name brand. I've kind of looked up, and the people at VIAIR are saying that, you know, they have a factory in China, but it's built to their specs. And you get pretty good support from what I hear, too, if you call them up, you know, or if you ever need parts for it. Comes with a little bag here full of filters. In here is a pair of filters. That's to keep dust. Goes on to the intake and keeps the dust out of there. Other than that, there's no maintenance. All you have to do is change the filters and clean it. It's an oilless air pump, so very little maintenance. And they even included a really nice canvas bag, really good quality zippers on it, etc., etc. Anyway, the thing I want to do today is do a little mod as far as a power hookup mod. You see here, it comes with alligator clamps. So the idea is you clamp this onto your vehicle battery, and then you start up your vehicle. You want to run your alternator because it draws 23 amps. So if you just have a single little battery in a vehicle, you could drain it quite quickly. Also, you want enough oomph to run the thing. So it's, they say, to start your engine. But what I'm going to do, since my fifth wheel has four big golf cart batteries in there, rather than always having to open my hood and run it off the vehicle battery, I'm going to run it off my coach batteries inside the fifth wheel. So I want to do a little modification here and add a port to the side of the rig. So I kind of did some research on what could handle that current, and it came up with a trolling motor. This is a Minn Kota brand, and it looks like it's Marnico connections, and it's a twist lock. See in there, so once you put it in there, it has an O-ring, so it's waterproof and everything. And I'm going to mount that on the side of the RV close to my batteries, And then I'll put that plug, I'll cut this cable, and I'll install that plug on that. And then, because I still want to retain the ability to use the clamps, I bought a second receptacle, so I'll mount the clamp wire on that, so that way I'll be able to either plug it into my rig, or, you know, if I'm helping someone else somewhere, I can go and, or if I'm just with the truck, I can use it off the battery like it was, comes from the factory designed to do. So, to get this mounted in the rig, I need to drill out 1 1/8-inch hole. I got myself a hole saw here, 1 1/8. And I also got myself some heavy hookup wire. This is a 8-gauge wire, because you're going to be doing 23 amps, so you don't want to use any thin wire. You need a wire that's capable of handling that amperage. So, let's get to it. Going to drill a hole in the side of the rig. So that thing went through there like butter, like you figured it would. See, we just got a thin layer of fiberglass and wood on the outside and some foam on the inside. But after that, the thing slides in there perfect. Gonna have to do some minor modifications on the inside here. It's light enough for me to show you. So you can see I had to cut out a hole and get rid of some of that foam that's inside there. Let me show you why I needed to do that. You can see on the receptacle here, there's a small ring that goes on, and then that clamps it. So with all that foam and wood there, this thing wasn't deep enough to put that ring nut on there, so I had to dig out some of that. This also goes on the outside and screws in, so should work out. So to do that nice square, I used my Makita multi-tool, or my Milwaukee, sorry. I don't know why I keep saying Makita. Just because I've always had Makita drills. But yeah, Milwaukee, and this kind of half moon thing, so I could get into that weird area and make a nice neat cut on that board. Really handy little tool to have around the RV. Okay, let's get going. Hook up all this wiring in there. I also have a 30 amp fuse, inline fuse here. It's part of my solar system in the past, and I upgraded to breakers, but that should do the job. 23 amps is the max amp, so a 30 amp inline fuse. And this has a 30 amp fuse on its own wiring. Why would I want to put another fuse in? And that's just to protect the wiring in the rig. Like, say something shorted out on this thing somehow, there'd be nothing to protect it short of a 200 amp catastrophic fuse that I have. So it's a good idea to fuse every piece of wire that you have in the rig, just in case. So I've attached the wires and remembered which number I put positive and negative, so I can match it on the plug. Got myself some marine grade silicone sealant. Put that in there, and I'll seal around the cover there, and around back I'll probably glob a bunch of sealant around the back of it too. That one should be okay. There we go. So that looks pretty good. Little port. And on the inside, give you a look there. Let's see, whoops. Look at the screw. There we are. Comes out there, and I just tacked it away to the side and run it up through. There's a nice hole there where the propane comes from the other side. Tank on the other side, nice convenient hole up there. This orange wire, if you're curious, that's I had trouble with my running lights. I was getting shorts in my running lights, and where it goes from the one side to this side, it was pinching up in the corner. They had just kind of laid it out in there, and I was getting problems where it was pinching and causing problems. So I just ran myself a new wire across. So let's go inside and I'll show you how I wired that into the battery bank. There we go, into the giant cluster of electronics and wires. Anyway, up here, this is where it comes through that hole. I found out that there was a nice ground lug up here into the right into the steel frame, so save myself some wire, I just ran the negative ground wire and attached it right there, and it'll find its way back to the battery bank through the frame. And the positive wire is clipped it along here and then fed it in right up into here, down, and that's where I installed a 30 amp inline fuse here. Down, 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 and then I found, just stuck it on the lug on the end of this catastrophic fuse. People might say, well, that's on the wrong end of the catastrophic fuse, but actually this is a second catastrophic fuse, because if you remember in a earlier video, I installed this one that sits right on the battery lug. So it's just, I left this in because it was a convenient kind of positive bus bar for me. So I think that should do good. It's a nice heavy 8 gauge cable. Should have plenty of current capacity. And the run is pretty short. The positive run here is, I don't know, maybe six feet, about 6 feet. And of course the negative run's only about maybe 18 inches, foot and a half, so that should work out well. Awesome, let's give her a test. Okay, so I've cut the original power cable and added the male connector, the male Marnico connector here, Marinco, I guess it's called, and the female over here. Just so I can still use my alligator clamps if I ever want to. Now this will plug right into my new port. Okay. There we go. Fire it up. Give her a test here. And it registers a lot higher. You have to let go to get an accurate reading. So let's let it go here for a minute or so. Definitely nice and quiet compared to that other one I have, kind of just screams. I like it though. Okay. So we've added about 8 pounds there. You saw the auto shut off working there. It doesn't continuously run unless you're needing it. There we've added about 10 pounds. Maybe took about a minute. Anyway, that's enough for today. Just wanted to get you kind of a look at it and see that mod that I did so that I can just plug it into the side of my rig easily. Don't have to go rooting around and finding the battery in the truck or whatever with those clamps. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to test it on a bunch of different tires. I'll see how long it takes to inflate one of these trailer tires and one of my Big Blues truck tires. I got a bicycle here I can test it on, and also my pinbox airbag I'll test it on, and then maybe go through with my likes and dislikes, get a final overview of it. So stay tuned for that video. Till next time, Ray from loveyourrv.com. Not too many people in the RV park right now. They had a long weekend last weekend and they all cleared out, but I'm sure they'll be back. It'll be some nice weather. Cheers, everyone. Oh, don't forget Angie. There she is, hanging out on her little bed, relaxing. Rough life for a beagle, I tell you. Go for a walk? Go for a walk?